Welcome to the Compatible Python 2 and Python 3 code video. In this video, we'll be looking at the core tools at your disposal for making your Python program work in both Python 2 and Python 3. We won't be writing any code in this video. I will purely present the code snippets that indicate how to deal with compatibility issues. This slideshow will be available in the description. It's very important to decide what versions of Python you want to support for your program or library. Python 2.6 introduced some forward compatibility modules, making it much easier for Python 2.6 to integrate with Python 3+. Because of this, it's discouraged that you support Python 2.5 or lower, as you'll have to jump through many hoops to make it work. There are still a few old systems going around with versions of Python lower than 2.6, so consider carefully if spending the extra time to support 2.5 or lower is worth it for your package. If you are starting a new project, I suggest you work in Python 3. And make it backwards compatible, rather than the opposite of starting with Python 2 and making it forwards compatible. Once your project is working in Python 3, try running it on the lowest version of Python you want to support. From here, you can start implementing the fixes and work towards your compatible package. The main concerns we are going to look at today is handling print for output, correctly handling exceptions, which can behave differently when handling multiple exceptions, handling the different division between Python 2 and Python 3, handling Unicode strings, as all strings in Python 3 are Unicode, and lastly, handling bad imports, as Python 3 has changed a few of the standard library modules to correctly follow naming conventions. Did you know the print function works in both Python 2 and Python 3? Well, sort of. Python 2's implementation is a little different. It works fine if you're doing just basic prints. However, if you want to print two separate strings, or print to a file, or change a line ending, you'll need to use the standard library module __future__ to force Python 2 to use the Python 3 implementation. Simply import print_function from the __future__ module, and the rest of the module will use the Python 3 implementation. Typically, catching a Python 2 exception will look something like the following. However, this will only work in Python 2. Since Python 2.6, the as keyword can be used to set the error variable in an except statement, which works just like it does in Python 3. So the following will work correctly in both versions. However, to correctly manage more than one exception type, you must put it in a tuple. Division. Here is an easy one, but it's also an easy one to forget and can cause you a headache giving you different results on two different versions. Simply import division from __future__ at the top of your module, and division in Python 2 will behave like it does in Python 3. Just like division, handling Unicode strings in Python 2 is as simple as importing Unicode_literals from the __future__ standard module. Then all of your strings will be Unicode strings in both Python 2 and Python 3. Python 3 renamed a lot of modules and moved certain modules around in the Python standard library. This unfortunately causes many issues for compatibility. Luckily, a neat fix is to use Python's try-except structure to detect which import. Here we try to import the Python 3 version of the Q module. But if we are running Python 2, the Q module with a lowercase q doesn't exist. So an import error is thrown. Thus, we can then as a result import the Python 2 version with the uppercase q. Some final notes to keep in mind. The input function is the last painful thing you'll have to deal with. Generally, when writing a library, you won't ever use input. But if you're writing a console application, you might cross it. There are two ways I would deal with this situation. Option 1 is to import input from built-ins. Option 2 is to manually check the system version info for Python. Last thing is, if you are porting Python 2 module to Python 3, check out the third-party library 6. It contains many tools for going forward and has tools for supporting earlier versions of Python 2. Alright, we are done. This is not everything that isn't compatible. There is quite a big list of possible problems that may arise, such as dealing with long integers or iterating through dictionaries. I'll put a link in the description to a neat cheat sheet by Ed Schofield, which if you encounter a problem that is not covered in this video, it should cover it. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful or informative. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.